Hi guys, welcome to Chris Ryan Golf. We are at the Belfry again today. We're in the Callaway Fitting Suite and I'm going to give you a really, really good one-armed drill that you can do on the range and in practice, which is going to give you some really good feels to improve your downswing and ultimately improve your shots. Now, before we start, we are not going to be hitting any shots with this drill. So before you start thinking, hang on, I can't even hit the ball as well as I'd like with two hands, let alone one, we are not going to hit any balls. It's just to give us the right kind of feels. The reason I like this drill is because it really targets three key areas of the swing that I see golfers get wrong day in, day out. Those three things are the pivot, which is basically how the body works through the golf ball. That is something that golfers don't tend to do well enough. We are going to address the angle of the golf club in the downswing. Often golfers get that angle too steep. And the third one is the position of the lead wrist. So in this case, in my case, for a right-handed golfer, it's the left wrist, and we're looking at whether that wrist is flat, whether it's kind of cupped like this, or whether it's bowed like this. So these three things I see golfers get wrong day in, day out, and the three are very, very much linked. If we get the angle of the golf club wrong, so we stand the club up too much this way, get it too vertical, we will often see that coupled with a lead wrist which is too cupped, and that really means that golfer is going to struggle to pivot correctly through the golf ball. So, what is the drill? It is a lead arm drill. So, in my case, it's the left hand, but obviously, if you're a left-handed golfer, it's going to be right hand. What we're going to get you to do, I'll turn this way so you can see. We're going to get you to take a starting position. Okay, just take your normal address position to this golf ball. And I want you to just make a backswing until you feel that your lead arm is about level with the ground. Okay, so it's about horizontal. What I want you to do now, there's two different things I want you to do. I want you to rotate your wrist and feel as if you're pushing the back of the hand away. So in this case, it's more towards the camera, okay? What I want you to do then, I want you to keep the grip end here where it is, and I want you to feel that you just allow the club to lay down a little bit, okay? So we've got two movements there. I've twisted the grip effectively away from me, and I've allowed the club to lay down, or I've flattened the angle of that golf club, okay? So that's how I want you to do the backswing. I want you to do that. And as I say, we're not going to be too worried about where we are. We haven't got a golf ball. We haven't got a target. We just want you to make those moves. So what we're going to do, show that backswing, okay? Halfway back and stop, okay? Right hand off. Twist the grip away from me. Lay the club down. Right, from there, I want you to just use your pivot and move the golf club through into a full finish position. Okay? That's all I want you to do. Okay, I'm going to do that again for you. So back here, halfway, stop. Twist the grip away from me. Lay the club down a little bit, use the pivot, and go through to a full finish. When I say a full finish, you can see how the club is right the way around the back of my head, okay? And that is really, really important. So what you're going to do is you're just going to do a few of those in the range. You're just going to stand on the mat, and you know, I'll do it this way so you can see a slightly different viewpoint. I'm going to go back halfway. I'm going to twist the wrist away from me, lay the club down a little bit, and use my pivot to go right the way through to a full finish position, okay? For many of those golfers out there watching this video, if you struggle with high shots, fade shots, pull shots, slice shots, weak shots, misstruck shots, all those kind of things, you are going to find this is a very, very different feel to what you're currently used to, okay? If we look at the best golfers in the world, there are exceptions to every case, we know that, but a lot of them will have what we can see in that drill. They will have the front wrist, the lead wrist, a little bit more bowed, a little bit more twisted away from them, and they will have the club on a slightly lower swing angle, along a lower plane than maybe what you do, okay? These golfers from this position can use the pivot to deliver the golf club. If you are out there hitting those shots that we just mentioned, there is a very, very good chance, can't say for certain, but there is a very good chance that you have got this wrist cupped, twisted towards you, and you've got the golf club stood up too much, too vertical. From here, it would be very, very difficult to pivot correctly through the ball. So you're going to find that you tend to get more cramped, more stuck in your own way this way, can't deliver the club as well as we'd like, can't move the path maybe out to the right of the target, okay? So it's going to give you some incredibly different feels. It might even be worth taking your setup, going back and creating the opposite. So twist the wrist towards me, steepen the club, and just feel from there how much more difficult it is to get that golf club through into the golf ball, okay? Straight away you can see probably how that looks a lot more awkward for me to do. I can't use my pivot to deliver that club if it's stood up too much and my wrist is extended or sort of cupped, okay? So just go ahead again. We're going to go back. We're going to push the wrist away from us. working towards a more bowed position. Lay the shaft down a little bit, use the pivot, go right the way through, okay? It's a much, much more efficient way of hitting the golf ball, and if it's not the way that you currently hit the golf ball, it's gonna feel very different, okay? And that's ultimately what we're trying to do, to give you some good feels. I would tend to get golfers to do that with an impact bag. This may not be something you have access to. If you have, absolutely brilliant. For me, it just adds something down here, a little target. Obviously, the golf ball's quite small. This is much bigger. But it just puts a little bit more of an emphasis on what we're trying to do. And I'm right-handed. That's my dominant hand. I can still produce quite a bit of power if I do it this way. Twist it away, lay the club down, use my pivot. Okay, there's a lot of force going through that bag because I've used my pivot to deliver that golf club. Okay, and that's really what we're trying to do in this drill. Once you've done a few drills, go ahead and hit a few shots, okay? I wouldn't think too much what we're doing. Just go ahead and see if you can get some of those feels that you just had in that drill and hit some shots. Okay, pretty good, pretty happy with that one. Just do another one for you. Okay, and again, pretty good. So, give it a go, one-handed drill. Don't do it with the ball. Maybe you could do it with a tee peg. You maybe put something down there, maybe do this tee peg and try and maybe feel that you're working towards a target, but we're not gonna hit balls. It's to give us a feel, okay? The position of this lead wrist, the angle of the shaft and the pivot are very, very, often very, very good in good players and in poorer players who struggle with the shots we spoke about, they are often the three things that we see, you know, that aren't quite as we'd like. And this drill will give you a good feel on how you can maybe move towards those things. And if you can do that, I guarantee you'll hit some better shots on the golf course. You'll probably hit it a bit further. You'll definitely hit it more solid. And you'll definitely find that you can control the curvature on the golf ball much, much better. And that hopefully is going to lead to some better scores. Okay, so hopefully that made sense. It's a drill that you can do in your back garden. You can do it on the driving range. You know, you don't need to be hitting balls. It's just going to give you, as I say, some good feels. And that's really, really good for practice and development of your game. Okay, so thanks for watching the video, guys. Hope it made sense. Hope it's something you can go away and do. If you liked the video, then click the like button. If you have any comments, come on this video or any other videos you'd like me to do, there's boxes down there where you can post those. And you also, I would advise you to subscribe to my channel as well. Subscription is free. It just means that you won't miss out on any of the content that I'm uploading. Okay, so as I say, thanks again for watching, and we will see you again next time.